Good morning and a warm welcome from me. Guys, today I'm going to explain you how to create a simple web page and make a search from that page to your database and display the search result on another web page. So guys, it's really very simple. You don't need even a bit of programming language to do this. I'm showing the proper page. You can customize your search. Okay, so let's see how to do that. For that purpose, you need a software called Microsoft Extension Web 4. So download it from Microsoft site called Microsoft Extension Web 4. Install it on your machine, on your system, and open it. Go to the site, click on new site, and click on empty site. Just do an OK. Once you do that, it will create a blank site. Thereafter, you have to create two pages. First of all, go to File, New and ASPX. The first page, or two pages, you have to create two pages. First page would be for that purpose, in which you have to there will be a box, search box, and a search button where you enter the data which you want to search and make a search. Okay, so for that purpose, I had just open a blank page and save it by the name called as search.aspx. Okay, S-E-A-R-C-H, or name it as a search and save it. Since I had opened ASPX, so by default it will be saved by in ASPX. Okay, search.aspx has been created. Now we need require a page as well to display the search result which will fetch data from the database. So what we need to do is that I would create a ASPX page, and after that we would as well save it and rename it as result. Suppose that it is going to display the result. Okay, so guys, that's fine. So now save as well this page. It is saved. So two pages are created. This is the side view. This is the first page. This is the second page. So what you need to do is that first is that you have to look up for your database. So depending upon your requirement, if you want to use MySQL database, you can use as well. If you want to use MSX Access database, you can use MSX Access as well. So for the sake of simplicity here, I am going to explain you with Microsoft Access database. So just create one data blank database, rename it whatever you wish. I am willing to have a database to fetch contact, phone numbers, office, email ID, and these all things. So I'm writing here the name is contacts. Okay, and do a create. Once you create it and create, I have already created here, so it will go to my documents and it will create like this. Once you create it, I have already created. Just rename it the labels, what you want to make search and what you want to display on the web page. Fill some data on that. I have already filled it, and do a save. Once you do that, guys, after that, what you need to do is just go to file. Once you go to file, go to import and click on file, add file, add your database file. This is contact, and do an OK. Okay, so now the first thing, go to now search.aspx page, and here we need to add the search box. Click on ASP .NET control from the toolbox. Click on standard. Once you click there, you would get an option there, and that text box. Click on drag and drag it and place it over here. Click here and rename the box label. I want to search by last name, so I click here in the ID button. I will click here last name, L-A-S-T-N-A-M-E. Okay, I just want another button to make a search. So from the standard ASP.NET, I would choose a button and drag it here. Again, click on button, and in the appearance section, name the button what you want to display. Since we are going to search, we will be right here that search on that button. Okay, so it will search. But we also need to specify that once data is entered in this box and someone click on the search, where to go. This page will be redirected to a page called results.asp. So the post back URL, you have to set here the post back URL. Write the name of the next page, so that would be results.aspx, results.aspx. Okay, so that's all. What you need to do is that is save this page. That's it with this page. Now go to the result page, where we have to display the data. Click on the result page. After that, go to the standard ASP controls. After that, go to the data. Okay. Once you click on data, once you click on data, you would have a called the grid view here. Just drag it and drop it to your design view, and choose your data source. Click on new data source. Since we are using Access database, so you use your Access. If you want to do the next, browse for your database file and do the next. Once you do the next, click on specify the columns from table view, and in this region you have to select this would you have to select whatever you want to display from the field. Okay, so I want to display the company name, last name. I would make a search by last name, first name, email address, job or business phone number. I want to display on the page, display page. Then somebody make a search by last name. Okay, so click here. Now where add a column that I'm willing to search by the last name. So I click here last name, go to the source, click on source, and since this would be in the form of a form, so click here form, and write here the exact name from which you want to search, which you have mentioned in your Access database as well as in that name, in that form. So I have written here that LAST and AME, don't miss name it. Okay, and click here on add, and do an okay. Once you do that, do the next and text query. Okay, and finish it. Once you finish it, just save the page. Okay, and go to your site view. It is ready to work. Click on the search page and preview in browser. Since I have multiple browsers installed here, so it is showing like this. Once you click here, you would get your results. Search page displayed here. So let's see. Yeah, it has been displayed in multiple browsers. This is Mozilla Firefox. Okay, it is name is search here. Now write the name of whatever you want to search. Let's see the database. First name, I have this is Pandey here. Okay, I'm going to search by Pandey. This all parameters should be displayed. So I would search by Pandey. Okay, let's see PANDEY and make a search. Yeah, that's gone, and the place is displayed now. Okay, go back again. So make a search by your other name. What would you like to search? Suppose as Pathak. PATHAK Pathak. Okay, what PATHAK Pathak, and I would make a search. That's it, guys. Okay, isn't it easy? Don't need programming language, no? So guys, thanks a lot for watching. I have lot much to say. I have lot much many more video tutorials on web designing as well, and hardware networking, and many useful technology tips on my YouTube channel. So kindly subscribe to my channel if you like my work, guys. If you have any confusion, just comment in the comment box. I like my videos, and I would keep you waiting, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. I love you. Bye bye.